Hi, and welcome to the channel. In this tutorial, we're going to continue our journey of learning the GrandMA3 lighting console. One of the great things about the GrandMA3 consoles from MA Lighting is that everything is customizable. That can be really helpful because you can make the user interface just the way you like it. But it can also be one of the things that make it really hard to get started with the MA Lighting consoles. In both GrandMA 1 and GrandMA 2, you had to build all your views from scratch when you started out for the first time. GrandMA 3 gives you a little help with some predefined views, but you still have to know how to change things around to be able to have exactly the work environment you need. Knowing what you need can be one of the hardest things to figure out. If you have very little experience with lighting consoles, and that's why I'll try to explain this to you very slowly. Let me know in the comment section if you have worked with lighting consoles before or even if this is the first time with a lighting console. I'm also interested in hearing from you if you have any questions about the video and if you need me to clarify something. Remember to give the video a like if you find it useful and maybe even click the subscribe button if you don't want to miss any future episodes. The reason that I take it so slowly in these videos is that I think it's important not only to know how you do different things on the GrandMA 3 console, but I also think it's very important to know why you do it. When you're working with views, you need to know what's possible in the windows and you need to know how to build your own views. This will help you later when you figure out you need a different view than the ones MA built for you, and it'll also make you less afraid of breaking something because it's quite easy to fix. In the last episode, we looked at patching 4 different lighting fixtures into the console. We patched 48 fixtures, and that was 2 types of moving lights, 1 type of strobe, and some demo channels. If you missed that episode, there's a link in the top right corner right now. Maybe you want to watch that first to catch up to what we're doing now. To start out with views, you also need to know something about the way you can call them. You can build many different views, and you're not limited to a certain number. The way you set up your console determines how much view real estate you want to make use of. Let's start with looking at what MA Lighting built for you. If you look here in the right side of your window, you can see some different boxes with numbers on it. You have fixture, preset, sequence sheet, phaser, 3D, and help. All these are called views, and you can click on each of them, and you can see the screen changes to a new view. If you open one of the other windows on the console, screen 2 or screen 3, you will notice that you can select the same views on all screens. But you probably don't want to have the same views on all screens, so we need to get rid of some of them to make room for some custom ones we build ourselves. So let's delete the entire row of views right now. Go to the command section right here, locate the delete button, and click it. Close the command section on the small X up in the top right corner. Notice that the command line has the command delete ready for you. Click the first view and it disappears. We now have deleted the first view from screen number 1, but you still have it on all the other screens. Actually, you can still find it in the console's view pool, but let's look at that later. Do the same for all other views. Delete all of them right now. To start over with a blank screen, you navigate to the small cog icon up here. Notice that there's a small window over here called Display. Here you have the option of clearing your screen to start over with a blank screen. Press Delete this screen. Now we are looking at a blank screen with nothing on it, and all the predefined views has been deleted. It's now time to start building our own views the way we like it. The screen on the GrandMA 3 console is black. But if you click on it, you'll be prompted by this box. When you click the screen, you are prompted with a lot of options. So let's start with locating the group view. You find the group view under the tab Pools. When you locate the Groups icon, click it with your mouse or your finger if you are on a real GrandMA 3 console. This fills up the entire screen with small squares. Every square is a place where you can store a group. A group consists of a selection of fixtures, selected in a certain order. Why that matters is for a later tutorial, just know that it's important. The group view has over 100 potential groups in it, and we don't need that many. Click and hold the small triangle in the corner to scale the window to a smaller size. I think this is space enough for our small demo show. The group window is ready. Now we need to populate the rest of the screen. Click on the empty space and locate the Presets tab. If you haven't patched any fixtures yet, the Presets tab will be empty. If you want to learn how to patch, see the previous video on this channel. In the Presets tab, select Position. Scale it to fit the screen to the size that suits you. I think this is going to be enough. Click on an empty cell again and find the color preset. Scale it the way you want it. Do the same for gobo, do the same for beam, and do the same for focus. If you made a mistake or need to close a window, click on the small MA logo in the top left corner of the selected preset and press the delete window. The last thing we will add in this view is the 3D view. It might be a little advanced for this tutorial, but I think it's very important that you can see what you're doing and how it affects your lighting fixtures. In the next episode, we will set up our fixtures in the 3D view, but let's just save it into our view for now. Now we have made our first view, but we haven't saved it anywhere yet. Let's do that. Navigate to the command section. Press Store. Notice that the command line reads Store. Close the command section and click on the first view hotkey. Congratulations, you have now built and saved your first view. Labeling the view is important right now. It's no problem to remember what we have built, but later when your show grows, it's important that you can identify it again. Now we need to start working with fixtures in our show. Remember in the last episode where we patched our first fixtures? Let's start with making some groups for the four different fixture types. Remember what we called them? 701 through 712 is Mac Viber Profile. 601 through 612 is Mac Aura XB. 301 through 306 is Atomic Strobes. And 101 through 112 is our generic demo channels. Let's start from the top. Open the command section and type 701 through 712 and press please. This will select all your Martin Mac Viber profile spots. Click on the Store button and close the command section again. Notice that Store is written in the command line down here. Click on the first square in your groups window. You have now made your first group. To be able to remember what you have stored where, it's very important that you always label or name your groups. Luckily, it's very easy. Click on the group to make sure it's highlighted. Simply type all vibers on your keyboard or directly on your screen, depending on if you are on a real console. Go back to the command section and locate the clear button. Click the clear button three times. I'll come back to later why you click it three times. Just remember that you have to click it three times. Do the same for the other fixtures. Type 601 through 612 in the command section plus the please button. Press store. Close the command section and click the second square. You have now saved that group and now you can label it all auras. Clear three times. Type 301 through 306 and store it on the number three and call it all atomics. And last but not least, type 101 through 112 and store it in number four and name it all demo. We have now made four groups in our new view. There are many different views and you have a lot of options in the GrandMA3 console when creating views. But in this tutorial, we try to keep it very simple. So if you are a new user, you have the option to follow along and learn as you go. In the next video, we set up four different fixture types in our new 3D window. It's quite simple to do that. And when it's done, you can see exactly what you're doing when we are starting to make some simple programming. If you find any value in these videos, please like the video and maybe even subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any episodes in the future. And please let me hear from you in the comment section if there's something you want me to clarify. You are also more than welcome to suggest future topics we should cover in the video as well. Thanks for watching and see you next time.